Hello everyone, now we are going to see core Java basics. This is the first tutorial from Java Crackers. In this tutorial we are going to discuss about what is Java, where it will be useful and its features, about JDK, JRE and JVM architecture, how to set path to execute Java programs, simple Java program and its working behavior. Finally, we are going to discuss about naming conventions. What is Java? Java came into existence in the year of 1995. James Gosling and his team members, popularly known as Green Team, they started this development at Sun Microsystems. See, he is James Gosling. Initially, Java name is Oak, and later it changed to Java. Oak was renamed as Java in the year of 1995 because it is a trademark by Oak Technologies. Originally, Java was developed for small embedded systems in electronic appliances like set-top boxes. If we see Java version history, it starts with JDK Alpha and Beta. It was released in the year of 1995 by James Gosling from Sun Microsystems, and later on JDK 1.0, 1.1 and so on came into market. Finally, Java version stabilized with Java SE8. It came into market in the year of 2014, March 18th. This is popular because of this built-in feature called platform independency. In the sense, if you compile a Java program, it will generate .class file. We can use this .class file in any platform. That coding won't change from platform to platform like C, C++. Java is an object-oriented language, nothing but it follows OOPS concept. It is high-level language and secured. This Java is secured because memory allocation and deallocation will take care by interpreter. In C and all, we have to write coding for memory allocation and deallocation. So C is not that much of secure when compared to Java. Java has some built-in features such as object-oriented, simple and familiar, dynamic, garbage collected, secure and robust, high performance, portable, distributed, platform independent, multi-threaded. Now we will see one by one. Java is an object-oriented language, nothing but it follows OOPS concept. And in Java, everything is an object. Java can be easily extended since it is based on the object model. Object-oriented simplifies software development and maintenance. In Java, this object can be extended easily and we can change it easily. Java is simple and familiar because the guy who knows about C and C++ can easily do coding in Java if he knows simple basics. And Java is dynamic. You can load new classes at runtime also, and garbage collected. Java is a garbage collector. We already discussed that to make memory allocation and deallocation, we have to write coding in C and C++. We have to use pointers in C, but in Java, this process will take care by interpreter. Java is a garbage collector, so it is a secure one and robust one. Java has high performance. Java compiler is a just-in-time compiler, nothing but JIT. This just-in-time compiler feature is, if you write a Java code and if you compile it in one platform, we can use that generated .class file in any platform. Like if you write a program in Windows and you want to use that generated .class file in any other platform such as Linux or Unix, we can run that .class file easily. But in C and C++, we have to compile it again and we have to run that program. If it needed, we have to do some code changes also in C and C++. But in Java, it is not needed. We can use the .class file to run in any platform. That means just-in-time compiler. And we are going to see about portable. Java is portable because of this feature called just-in-time compiler. And it is a distributed one. By making use of RMI and EJBs, it is a distributed one. We may access files by calling the methods from any machine on the internet. Suppose I am going to write a program in my laptop. Some other guy in some other place want to access these methods in this class. He can do that through internet. Java will support this one. And Java is a platform independent one. We already discussed about this. Java contains one more feature called multi-threaded. This allows programmer to write program that can do many tasks simultaneously. This program will do simultaneously by using same memory space. Now we are going to see about JDK, JRE and JVM architectures. JDK is acronym of Java Development Toolkit. JRE is acronym of Java Runtime Environment. JVM is acronym for Java Virtual Machine. Now we will see this architecture. This is JDK and JVM architecture. See here, JDK, inside JDK, JRE and JVM are available. Inside JRE, JVM is available. Combination of JRE and development tools is nothing but JDK. Combination of JVM and library files such as deploy.jar, charsets.jar and JVM is a JRE. Now we can see JDK and JRE physically. JVM is a virtual one. In the name itself, it said like virtual. Now I will show this deploy.jar, charsets.jar inside JRE, and we will see this development tools such as Java, Java C in my machine. Go to program files, Java, JDK. See, JDK is a combination of development tools that are available in bin. Development tools such as java.exe, javac.exe, javadoc.exe, javah.exe, all these are development tools. And JRE, combination of JRE and development tools is nothing but a JDK. And JRE is a combination of some library files such as charsets.jar, deploy.jar and JVM. JVM is a virtual one. We can't see here. This is the architecture of JDK. Now we will see how the program execution will happen in Java. see this code execution process for Java. First, we are going to compile Java code, for example, doc.java, example.java, by making use of compiler. It will generate dot class file. If it is a doc.java, it will generate doc.class file. It is a bytecode. And by making use of class loader, we are going to load this dot class file into runtime data areas. From this runtime data areas, execution engine will take the dot class file, and finally it will execute that dot class file, and it gives us the output. This is code execution process for Java. It is a simple one. Here, for compiling, we will use Java C space doc.java, and to run this, we will use command called Java space this file name doc. Like that, we will use. We will see in example program how to do this one and all. Before writing a sample program, we should have to know about naming conventions that we should have to use in Java. Generally, it won't cause any damage to program execution, but as a good developer, we should have to use these conventions. First, package name. That package name should have to start with lowercase letters. Sorry, all the letters should be small case. Constant names, all the letters should be capital always. And if there are two or more words are available, that should have to separate with underscore. Variable name, it should have to start with small case. If two or more words are available, that second word, from second word onwards, it should have to start with capital letter. It is nothing but camel case. Java follows camel case. Method name, should have to start with small letter, and it should be a verb. Class name, it should be a noun, and it should have to start with capital. And interface name, it should have to start with capital I. It suggests that it is an interface, and it should be an adjective. Now we will see how to execute a program. Now I am going to write a simple program. Class name should be like Java Crackers C. Here that class name should have to start with capital letter. And now we are going to write a main method, public static void main string args. System.out.println. System.out.println is used to give output in the console. Welcome to Java Crackers. Yes, now we should have to save this file. Now we are going to save it in desktop. We should have to remember one thing: while saving this file, we should have to save with that class name. We saved this file. Now we are going to execute this one. Open command prompt. Select that path that where that Java file is available. It is available in desktop. now we are going to execute that file. First we have to compile it. Java crackers dot java are only accepted if annotation processing explicitly required.
We got this error like Java crackers dot java are only accepted if annotation processing is explicitly required. This error is because of here we mentioned as dot java. It should be small letter, it should be, it shouldn't be a caps. Java is a typecaster, it is a case sensitive language. Now here we missed something. Java crackers, it is a class name, it is not a method. Yeah, compilation done. After compiling this program, dot class file is created here, java crackers dot class. Now we are going to run that compiled dot java file. Yeah, we got a message like welcome to Java crackers. This is about basics, and here we have to discuss about all these things like public, why we should have to use public, why we should have to use static keyword, why we should have to use what is void and what is this main method. We will discuss all these things in next tutorial, and thank you very much. Please subscribe to Java crackers. Thank you very much.